4 years ago, we spoke about Jonathan Crone. He was a 13-year-old conservative kid who gave a speech at CPAC, and it was the most obnoxious speech of all time. If you don't believe me, let's watch.
Life, less government, and personal responsibility. I believe that this is the key, that principle itself is the key to conservatism. Because in many ways, if you do not have a principled base, you do not have policy. And if you do not have policy, in many ways, you do not have an ideology.
I mean, did I make my case?
No, I know. And look, we made fun of the kid at the time, for which we are still being attacked. Like, how could you do it? He's a 30-year-old kid. And what we were saying is that he is really just all he's done, and you can go back and watch the whole video, is that he's taken what he's seeing from adults and copied it, right? And then it just adds like therefores along the way. And you know, therefore the policy is this, and it's this, right? But now let's also remember and play the video what I said at the time.
Uh-huh.
Okay, let's watch.
And the thing is, all of his Republican talking points are so simplistic, and he thinks he's so smart.
I know,
because
I know.
Everybody encourages him. I get it. I mean, he's a 14-year-old kid. Remember, he could grow up to be a perfectly sensible guy, okay? God knows, you remember, I was a Republican when I was a kid.
Yeah.
Today I was remembering how I gave a speech senior year in high school in our debate class. We had a poli-sci class, mm-hmm. and I was a congressman there. I was Congressman Uger, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I gave a speech about how the Contras were like the American revolutionaries, how they were like George Washington and Thomas Jefferson, and we needed to give them a chance. Oh, I want to strangle that little jank. Okay, go back there. What an, now if I saw him, I'd be like, tell me about the Contras again. Right? So anyway, so the kid grew up to be perfectly fine. And I blame his parents more than anything else. But how do you tolerate that? Guys, okay? Okay, guys.
And guess what happened today? We find out.
He spoke to Politico, and he's no longer conservative.
What did I tell you?
He's 17 years old now, and basically he's saying that he has experienced an evolution of thought, okay, and that he's no longer conservative. I think it was naive. It's a 13-year-old kid saying stuff that he hadn't heard for a long time. I live in Georgia. We're inundated with conservative talk. He continues to say, the speech was something that a 13-year-old does. You haven't formed all your opinion. You're really defeating yourself if you think you have all of your ideas in your head when you're 12 or 13. It's impossible. You haven't done enough.
Which is almost exactly what I said at the time. How does a 13-year-old know really what his political beliefs are? He just gets spoon-fed the stuff. So that's why you can't blame the kid too much. And it didn't take long. You know, 4 years later, he's like, yeah, all that stuff turned out to be nonsense. Gay marriage, what does he think of it now? Win. Yes, in favor.
Okay, gay marriage in favor. Obamacare, he says it's a good idea. Who would he vote for in November? He said probably Barack Obama. His favorite TV shows, The Daily Show and The Colbert Report.
Win. I love it.
His favorite magazine, The New Yorker. And best of all, the college that he will be going to is NYU.
Okay. Now, what I love about this story is conservative heads exploding. Because they love this kid when he was on their side. They're like, you see that? Even a 13-year-old knows. What a genius, genius. This kid is our kid. And then later, he's like, nah, it turns out, I didn't know anything. And the minute I learned even something, I realized, oh, you guys are totally wrong. So what happened now? Rush Limbaugh, all the conservatives, said, what happened? Now, I guess now you're going to say the kid is right again, right? No, all of a sudden, nothing about the kid, right? And the second thing that I like is that the conservatives are going to look at them and be like, see, we knew it. Daily Show and Colbert Report, corrupting the minds of kids.
Mm-hmm.
Now, they're not getting that, no, you originally corrupted his mind. And the minute he grew up a little bit, he was like, boy, that makes no sense.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so in reality, now the guys who were quoting him, they literally, like Newt Gingrich, Bill Bennett, they had quoted him, like Jonathan Crone says.
That is so embarrassing.
That's, I know, isn't that embarrassing? Like, he's a 13-year-old. Who cares what he says? And so, again, we were right. You shouldn't have quoted a 13-year-old because there's some chance he's going to change his mind by the time he's 17, and there's some chance he's 13! Okay? So, I love the fail on the part of conservatives who thought that this proved their case.